Antique guru Drew Pritchard is in Grimsby at a firm run by the same family for more than 100 years.
Whoa, my word.
He's bargaining on a decorative poster that celebrates Britain's bygone engineering past.
50 quid?
50?
I can't pay any more.
Yeah, 50.
Marvellous. Thank you. These sort of engineering posters, people really like them. I recently sold two large ones to a lady for her kitchen. They go anywhere. Ooh, look at that little tug. That's top. Look at that. I don't suppose you want to get rid of this, do you?
Well, it's not one of our old boats.
No? Really?
No. These are our old boats.
What, you built these?
No, we actually own these trawlers.
Did you?
Yeah.
There's this very well done, but it is scratch-built trawler called Samantha. It is not one of their fleet. It's already on a stand. It's ready to go. Looks very saleable. It's right in front of me, so we'll have a go at it.
This ship is actually a model of a tugboat used to tow cargo ships and is based on a style of boat from the late 60s. Made from wood, the name Samantha may have a personal connection to the person who built it, and it could be worth around £450.
So what's it going to take to buy Samantha, then?
Samantha, what would you think?
Give myself a fighting chance of getting rid of it. 250. I think I can get, on a bad day, I'll get 350, 400 quid for it, so I've got to give myself that margin, otherwise it isn't worth doing.
OK. Yeah. Yeah, 250, be fine.
Marvellous. With certain things, you don't have to do anything to. You can make a very quick profit on them and turn them over, and then the person that buys them is still going to feel good because they don't feel like they paid too much as well. I think that's about right for it. I think somebody would be happy with that.
Next, Drew heads into the boardroom, a place filled with mementos from the firm's past.
This is the history of Bacons around the walls. Edwin Bacon, the first, known locally as the Governor.
He looks like a hard nut, doesn't he?
He started it all.
There's some pictures on the wall of the great and the good to do with Bacon. And Mr. Bacon, is the Governor, the guy who started it all, ended up having 900 employees in Grimsby. That is good business, no matter where you look at it. That's nice tea.
It is, yeah. Turn it over to change the date.
That's an iron and steel supplier. I've given you that. We're going over things in the office, and there's all the sort of Bacon stamps for the ledgers, and there's a huge ledger on there. But amongst them, there's this little thing that T picks up, and it's a little brass date thing, so it's a calendar number. So as you flip it over, the next day falls down. It's been a gift from a rep. Today, it's a charming little thing that will look good in the shop.
This desktop day calendar was given to the company by Austin's Iron and Steelworks from Dewsbury, Yorkshire. Made from brass, it probably dates from the 1950s or 60s and could be worth around £50.
Tenner?
15 for that? Brilliant. Thank you.
It's just a very tactile, small piece that's ideal for the shop. People, just anything like that, you're not going to see another one. There probably isn't that many in existence. It's a throwaway item, but it just has a certain charm to it.
Righto.
OK, so everything to go again?
Everything in here, yeah. Yeah. These are apparently
cool,
from the War Office.
They will be, yeah. It's about colour, age is absolutely bang on.
We've got two or three dotted around.
They're not the best looking things, but they are saleable. I feel like I've got a proper job now.
Do you?
Yeah. I haven't, though, have I?
No.
No.
That's where they'd let you have your crayons in the office. Ruth, you said no glitter, though, you know. You like the glitter.
That was everywhere.
Yeah.
While I'm sat here, there's something else that's taken my eye.
OK.
The Grimsby Meat Syndicate. I thought you just had fish up here.
No, the Meat Syndicate. I couldn't tell you the story of the Meat Syndicate.
So I'm sat there mulling this over now about the desks, and something catches my eye on the wall, and it's this brass door sign that says the Grimsby Meat Syndicate. The sign itself is made out of a strip of sort of 5mm brass. It's then been engraved, so it's called flatbed engraving. It's a nice little thing of times past.
The Grimsby Meat Syndicate was part of a charity set up during the First World War, distributing foodstuff from around the British Empire to the families of local soldiers. With its strong local connections, it could be worth around £100.
Do you want to sell it?
Yeah, I could sell that.
Yeah? 50 quid?
50 quid would be fine.
Brilliant. 50 quid for a giggle like that. Okay. Marvellous. the Grimsby Meat Syndicate. You have to think, this sign was made for a door, so it was made for the syndicate. So that means it had its own office somewhere. So this was a serious business. And Grimsby may not be today, but certainly was in the past, a real powerhouse of the north. This is just a little sort of sticking your toe in the past, a nicer time. Any day I get invited to an engineering works and get free rein to wander around it, that's always fun for me. We came here today to buy industrial furniture, lighting and equipment and benches and lockers and all sorts of stuff. Got none of that, but I've still saved four interesting pieces that will go through our hands, turn us a profit and go into somebody's house where it'll be loved.
Thoroughly enjoyed it. Nice talking to T and Drew. Some of the items, yeah, I was surprised that he took, but, you know, he's got the eye for that kind of thing.
Well, that was good.
It was.
Enjoyed that. It is a shame we didn't get anything down in the sort of engineering shop, but it just wasn't right. I was happy with what we bought. The ship model. It's got to be worth 400 quid, hasn't it?
Got it all day long, I thought, yeah. You have been a bit of a trawler yourself over the years, haven't you?
I prefer to think of myself as an old tug.
An old tug.
An old tugger.